Hey everyone, so today I am talking about choosing between becoming a doctor and a PA. Just right off the bat, there's no right or wrong answer necessarily. It is a very individual decision. You know, I had to run through these pros and cons before I eventually applied and got in and went through PA school. So I just wanted to create a resource and a video where I can list all the pros and cons that I can think of through my years of being in healthcare, hearing all the different perspectives so that hopefully you can come to the decision of what's best for you, knowing all of the facts. Alongside with talking about this, I thought it would be fun to do a little bit of an painting process video of this idea I've had in mind for a little while. So let's go ahead and get started. So the first thing people usually think of when it comes to PA versus doctor is the amount of time of being in school. You know, obviously as a PA, instead of doing 2 years of didactic in classroom learning, you do 1 year. And instead of doing 2 years of clinical rotations like physicians do, we do 1 year of clinical rotation. A big pro, you know, you're paying less in tuition, you're spending less of your time in school, you get to go out and work quicker. And so, you know, for some people that's great, especially depending on your situation in life. Of course, you can end up spending more years in school as a PA if you decide to do a PA residency, but I really don't know much about that since I never did one. So yeah, I can't speak to that really. First thing is less time to become a PA and more time to be a physician. The second thing that I found to be quite important was that as a PA, you're able to switch specialties without having to train again. So for example, I was in psychiatry at my last job. You know, I'm applying to jobs now and I'm applying to a wide variety of specialties because we can train and learn on the job. Whereas as a physician, you have to decide what residencies you want to apply to. And then, you know, once you do get into a residency, that is the specialty you're going to practice in. Of course, you can always go back and get another residency for another specialty you may like, but obviously it's easier in the sense of being a PA to work in different specialties quite easily. That was a big pro for me. I'm an indecisive person, and if you're that kind of person too, the idea of being nailed down to one specialty might be a little daunting. So that is a pro in my book. I've kind of already mentioned this earlier, but a third thing is really expense. Especially if you're a person that's gonna have to take out loans to be in school. Obviously, it's going to be more expensive to be in medical school versus being in PA school. But at the same time, your salary as a physician is likely to be higher. Of course, that varies. You know, I've heard some interesting stories of PAs making a higher salary than some doctors in other states, but that's another story. But you're likely to, you know, make enough money to pay those loans back either way. But again, felt more daunting to take out a much higher loan amount going to medical school versus going to PA school. My fourth point is the competitive nature of applicants either way. I found, and this is actually a little bit more of a personal thing, maybe some other people don't notice this, but I feel PAs are less competitive in nature than pre-med students or being a med student. I feel like there's a lot of competition in undergrad when you're applying to medical school. And you know, there probably is to a degree with PA school, but once you're in PA school, like, we're all gonna graduate and be PAs at the end. So I found the environment to be really supportive and helping each other. Whereas I feel like when I was around more of the pre-med crowd or medical students, you know, you're competing to one, get into these very hot spots to get into medical school. But on top of that, you're competing for the residency that you want. And some specialties have limited spots. And if that's your dream specialty, you know, you really gotta fight for that and make sure you're on top of your game. So I just, in general, I'm not very competitive in nature. In other areas of my life, I also like less competitive things. Like for example, I love yoga and I love the concept of you do what you can on your mat and don't worry about anybody or anything else. And so just transitioning that into the atmosphere of pre-PA versus pre-med, I just felt it was a little more welcoming on the PA end. I think I'm on number 5. This is more of a con for a PA, but a pro for a physician, which is that sometimes as a PA, you don't always know the answer. And to make the argument, sometimes physicians don't know the answer either. But of course, we haven't been trained for as long as a physician has, and especially in the specialty, them doing that residency adds another 4+ years in their training. So sometimes you don't know all the answers to the questions. And so you really do have to take out time to learn, train under your supervising physician, feel confident to ask the questions, know your limitations, know your boundaries. And so I think that's important to know that you are likely not to be as educated or knowledgeable in that specialty as your supervising physician. Of course, there's always exceptions to everything I'm saying. Okay, and I'm gonna come back to this because I have to go do something really quick, but I will be back. The lighting might change, but I will be back for my next points. The lighting has changed a little bit, but hopefully not to the point where it's noticeable. Oh, Daisy wants to come say hi. Okay, we've got a guest joining us. Hi, Daisy. Just to stretch on the thing that I said last is the education and knowledge that a physician has obtained from going to medical school and furthermore doing residency for many a years cannot go unnoticed. Especially for me as a fairly new PA, I feel like their education greatly surmounts mine. You know, of course, as I gained experience in psych, I gained more confidence as well, and I really truly became an extension of the physician that I was working for, and it became easier and easier. So I just wanted to point that out. Point number 6. This is a negative on the PA side of things. So I do feel like there is a lot of stigma against PAs, and I think that's slowly getting better with time, but you will occasionally get the patient that says, I don't want to see you, I'm only comfortable seeing the doctor, or people that'll just say negative things about mid-level providers in general. You kind of have to have a little bit of a thick skin and maybe hearing some negative things in the medical field or even outside of the medical field about your career choice. But I really don't mind. I know my worth in the medical setting. I know how I help in the team setting. And I know that I understand my job and my role really well. So it doesn't really hurt my feelings, but just something to keep in mind that there can be negative comments made towards you because you're a PA and because people don't understand exactly what you do and what it means to be a PA. So there's a lot of patient education in that. And, you know, sometimes even with the medical team, you know, especially if you're the first PA somewhere, you have to explain yourself a bit more than maybe a doctor who just everyone really knows what a doctor is, right? So yeah, just being prepared that those questions will likely be asked, and you know, even if you get a negative response, doing your best you can to advocate for what you do. Number 7 is something that's not huge, but I just thought I would mention it. After you've graduated and are practicing medicine, you have to do CME hours, which stands for continued medical education. And that's to maintain your knowledge and education on things going on in medicine. As we know, medicine is, you know, forever changing. There's always new things coming up. And so to really keep your knowledge up to date, you have to complete CMEs. So for a PA, we have to do 100 CME hours in a 2-year period, whereas physicians in Texas have to do 48 hours every 2 years. So we have double the hours that we have to do, which again, isn't really a huge con for me. I don't mind learning and having a system that forces me to watch things. So I do keep my knowledge up to date. So not a huge con for me, but just something I thought I would mention. And number 8, and really my final thought, is that sometimes there can be limitations with being a PA. So for example, you know you want to be a surgeon, it's your dream to be a surgeon, there's nothing really else that you're interested in. You know, as a PA, you can't ever really be the surgeon. You can be, you know, first assist and get a really great grasp on things and really be the extra pair of hands that the surgeon needs. and be really good at your job, but you're never gonna be the surgeon. And so if that's something that's important to you, then, you know, or it's something you want to have that option in the future, then, you know, med school is probably the way to go there. Although, even when you're in med school, will you necessarily get the surgery residency? Not necessarily. And another thing that can be limiting are the particular laws in the state. Like, for example, in Texas, as a PA, I'm not allowed to sign and prescribe class 2 medications, which in my last job in psychiatry, that meant I couldn't sign off prescriptions for ADHD, stimulants. I would see the patient, evaluate them. I would make it a part of their treatment plan. I would even set up the prescription, but the doctor just had to sign it off. No, that's annoying, but it's not, you know, it's just not a deal breaker for me. Hopefully over time, those laws change and improve so that we can do our job better for the whole team and while still being under supervision of the doctor. So, you know, we'll see what's to come with that. I actually just thought of a ninth thing because I'm job hunting right now, so I want to add this in, is again another con, I think, towards the PA profession, but I feel like me trying to find a job here in Austin has been a little tough, and that's because the market feels like it's quite saturated. So I will say that, you know, when you are a PA pinned up against another PA for a specialty and one PA has several years experience in that specialty, whereas the other one doesn't but is willing to be trained, the clinic or doctor, whoever it is likely to pick the experienced PA because simply said, it's just less work for them. So, you know, in a saturated market, you're competing with highly qualified PAs. And, you know, whereas if you're a physician, you could really go up and open your own practice and you probably have more availability of options. Now, I will say if you're a PA and if you don't mind where you're going to be located and you don't mind what specialty you're going to go into, there's a vast majority of options for you. But I will say that if there's a specialty you want and you want to be in a very particular area, I do think it's a little tougher with the job market, and maybe it's post-COVID, but I remember having some difficulty as a new grad just because I didn't have experience. So just wanted to put that out there too, that the job hunt can be a little more grueling when you're a PA. Not to say it's ever no job, but it just feels like it might be harder than a physician to get a job. Okay, so that's it. The last thing I will say is that I think the best way to really get to know whether or not you want to be a PA or a physician is to watch and read things just like this of people who have been through it and are experienced to see what fits best for you and your lifestyle and your goals. Furthermore, you know, shadowing with a PA or doctor or talking to one, you know, I hate to say shadowing right now because of the pandemic, and I'm sure it's so hard to get through those doors, but if you have an opportunity, that's a great way to see firsthand. You know, if you can work as a scribe, if you can work as a medical assistant and therefore be in closer range of those providers, that's a great way to do it. I've been both. I really hope this was helpful to you guys. If you have any additional questions or comments, please leave them below. I'm happy to answer and help any way I can. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe, and I will see you for the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.